Hey guys, I'm going to scrapbook this photo here of my nephew and my niece. And what you can't see in this photo is the television set. And he just had, when he was little, he just had complete tunnel vision where the TV was concerned. Like, you put a movie on and you could just leave him there forever. I'm not saying his parents did that, but it was possible. And this isn't really a kill the kit video. I've kind of gotten off of that a little bit, but I wanted to show you for my May kit. I already have the June kit, but for the May kit, this is what I have left. I have three sheets of plain cardstock, which is odd because typically I use these and the pattern papers go away. And I'm not going to show you the embellishments I have left or anything like that, but this is all I have to work with as far as pattern paper goes. And this is not only the May kit, this is all of the scraps from all three of the kits that I've gotten. So February, March, April. No, I don't think I got February. Yeah, I did. February, March, April, and May. So here are all of the scraps I have left from those 4 months. And in looking at my options for solid cardstock, I thought the white was a little too stark. Or maybe white will work. Hold on. Changing my mind already. It still looks a little stark to me. I think I'm going to go... How does that look on the gray? Can't really see that pattern on the gray. You know what? I think I just changed my mind. I think I'm going to use the white. But I don't know if you can see this. Let me pull it up here and see if you can. You may not be able to see the texture on that. That is not like a cloth texture. It's kind of like... Okay, I don't even know what that texture would be. But it's not like the normal... Like, this would be the normal texture. Can you see that? What I consider the normal texture. And then if I pull this all the way up there... See, it's kind of bumpy. You see? So anyway, I'm not going to use that textured side. All of that to say that. I'm not going to use that textured side. I'm going to use the smooth side of this white cardstock and these scraps. And that's all I really have left. So, as far as paper's concerned. So I did pull out some paints. I got this at... where did I get it? Look, and one of them is all kinds of out of there. I got these years ago at Tuesday Morning, I think. Look at that. Get in there. And I've had them sitting around. I've used them a couple times. And I have my watercolor brushes, and I have a water cup here. But there's no water in it. Let me tell you about my day yesterday. I ruined my coffee table because I spilled nail polish remover. Pure acetone nail polish remover because I ate steamed crabs over the weekend. I'm vlogging, you guys! I ate steamed crabs over the weekend, and I ruined my... I ruined my shellac manicure. So I needed to take that off because it was driving me insane. So I sat down at my living room table to take it off and proceeded to pour the pure acetone nail polish remover all over my living room table. Not good. And then I came down here into my scrap room and did some painting and proceeded to drop the paint all over the floor. So, yeah. We're not filling this cup up until we're absolutely ready for it. Yesterday was a bad day. So this is all, this is it. I don't know where we're going. Holy cow. I don't know where we're going, but we'll see when we get there. And thank you guys for watching. Hey guys, so if you survived that intro video, which was all kinds of random and all over the place, congratulations. I'm going to try to not be so random as I go through and narrate this layout that I'm working on now. So basically the first part of this video, I'm just going to play around with all of these scraps that I have left to figure out a way to, one, maximize my usage of them because I want to get rid of them, and to also make it look like it's not just a random hodgepodge of papers that I'm putting together. It is, but I don't want it to look that way. So... I don't know the manufacturers on a lot of these papers, but like I said, they all came in the Studio Calico kits for the last couple of months. And I really liked that rainbow-ish kind of paper. I felt like it gave that that white cardstock a lot of color. And it also, using that rainbow sort of striped paper there, it gave me a lot of options
to bring in other colors, which worked well with the scraps that I had left. So, you know, it was more my, it was my grounding piece of paper to add these additional pieces of scraps without them looking all random, because they picked up colors that were in the rainbow paper there. So that was the reasoning behind the choice. And I'm just trying to get my layers straight here. I don't do layering so well. I don't understand yet, like, how to glue them all down. You know, once you get them set, like, I don't know how to go about gluing them all down so they don't all shift around. It's crazy. But anyway, I really like this wave paper here, so I'm going to cut the border strip off of that, the manufacturing strip, and use a little bit of that at the bottom. And basically the first part of this layout, and the main part of this layout, is going to be figuring out how to put these layers down. And that is the that's the manufacturer strip I decided to use there, and then I'm going to put a little bit of it at the top too, to kind of, you know, make it, give it some continuity across the layout. So again, what I'm, the whole goal for me in using scraps is, although they're all randomly placed and they're all random papers left over from a kit, I don't want them to look so random. I want them to look like, you know, there was some thought went into where I was going, some thought went into where all of these things were placed. So, and I guess in the end, there is a lot of thought that goes into where all these things are going to go. So, you know. But it is very much just a layering, you know, looking at all of the different papers that I have and what I want to do with them. And pretty much what I do is, once I'm happy with placement, I glue it down right away. Because if I let myself just sit there and go through it and think, eh, maybe not, yes, maybe no, I will never get anything glued to the paper. So I learned a long time ago, for me, it's better to go with my first instinct, get those things adhered as quickly as possible, so that, you know, we don't have a lot of time or whatever to change our mind. You know, our scrapbooking time is limited, so I don't want to spend, you know, I don't want my pages to look terrible, like they just got thrown on the page, but at the same time, I don't want them to take 4 hours or whatever. About an hour a layout is about all I can handle. Hour and a half is pushing it. I don't, you know, I mean, I think it's great, you know, when other people, you know, if that's your style, I'm not, you know, if that's your style to spend, you know, that much time on a layout, that's great, you know, if that works for you. It just doesn't work for me. So scrapbooking is all about what works for you guys, you know, what works for each one of us. So it's not, there are no rules in scrapbooking, I don't think. That's a piece of flair that says Once Upon a Time, and basically I'm going to build on the journaling about, this is a layout that I did. I actually created this layout on June 14th. Today is July 28th, so I am very behind in narrating. This is that was an acetate tag from Basic Gray that came in the kit. I'm going to use my tiny attacher to attach it so that you know, there's no adhesive behind it that you can see. And then that piece of flair says Once Upon a Time, and I'm really going to build on that, because this layout, the picture from this layout was taken on December 24th, 2006. So Gabe at that point was 2 years old. He looks big for two, doesn't he, in that picture? Anyway, the layout was done on December 24th, 2006. The picture was taken on December 24th, 2006. I'm actually making the layout 7 years later, and I'm using, I'm actually going back to journal and talk about how, you know, at that point in his life, Gabe was just enthralled with the television. So I think it was because his parents didn't let him watch a lot of television, that when it was on, it was like complete tunnel vision. So the title of this layout is going to be Tunnel Vision, and that Once Upon a Time flair works there because I'm talking about something that happened obviously 7 years ago. So I'm making some circular embellishments here. I felt like with just putting the flair there, it kind of got lost. So I used some punches, a scalloped circle punches in 2.5 and I think in 2 inches and 1 inch, I think. And I'm just going to make three of those kind of layered. I don't really want to call them flowers, but I guess I don't know. You know, that just I'm going to layer them up using the different pattern papers and make a three, make three of them to go in the corners of the layout. And I don't know what I'm doing right now. I can tell from the volume bar that I'm in the room doing something. Oh, I was looking for other things to add. So like the layered embellishment in the upper left-hand corner has a 2-inch punched scallop circle. It has the 1-inch punched scallop circle, and then it has the flare badge in the center. So what I'm off doing now is looking for other things that are going to go in the center of those circular embellishments, those scallop circular embellishments, but I want them to be gray so that the colors match the gray in that Once Upon a Time flare, and it pulls the gray out from the background papers as well, because you know, I used a little bit of that wave gray paper at the top and then the waved gray paper at the bottom as well. So, and I thought, okay, well then maybe I'll use, I'm going through this just a bunch of different embellishments I had laying around on the desk. This is what is that? That is my, oh, those, that's the one of the just miscellaneous sort of drawers that I have that I throw like miscellaneous embellishments in, obviously. So I found that gray button that has like a darker gray, sort of almost doodled on button there. And I found these black paper clips that I thought I would use, but the black looked a little bit, it created a little bit too much contrast. There's a lot of black in the photo, so I feel like they would have worked, but they just didn't look exactly right to me. So I took them off, and then if you look in the upper left-hand corner there, I used this circular clip. It's silver. And I'm going to pull another two of them out in a minute after I finish this embellishment cluster here at the bottom. I don't know what I'm doing here. I was moving the adhesive, the foam adhesive around. I don't know why. And then I had that hello flag left from Basic Gray. It was from Basic Gray. I don't know. We got it in a kit, I believe. And I felt like if you read the journaling for this, I felt like the hello worked because you would say to him, Gabe, hello, Gabe, and nothing. He was tunnel vision. And here's a bunch of little silver clips that I have in this little jar that I got at IKEA. And I pulled out two more of those so that there would be a silver circular clip in each one of the embellishment clusters. And I just put some glue behind it to hold it there. And then with doing the layers, sometimes because I keep the adhesive in the center, I have to go back at the end to put down some more adhesive. So that's basically what I was doing there. And then I'm going to make the third embellishment cluster here. And yeah, so I turned it over. If I had been thinking, I would have used orange in the upper left and the lower right as the back as the bottom layer. But obviously I wasn't thinking, so I didn't want to then use orange in that lower left as well. I felt like it kind of threw the whole layout off. So with the two at the bottom being that soft turquoise in the back and then the orange on top of it, I felt like it gave the layout more balance. And then just adding this clip here. There we go. And then I'm going to have to look for something to put in the center of that last embellishment cluster. And I'm looking at all of the different embellishments that came. This is Basic Gray Hey You, I think, the transparencies and the die cuts. And these two say, I need the green little chevron arrow says, I want, the gray one says, I need, and I'm going to use some label stickers to put TV down there. This is a die cut that has all the days of the week in it, and I didn't like the colors, but I like the days of the week, and I'm going to use a marker to circle every day of the week, because he could have watched television every day of the week. So I thought that worked there. And I'm just going to use my aqua glue from Tombow Mono to put these die cuts down. If you can cover the entire back of the die cut with adhesive, it works out really well because then you can't see the adhesive at all because the whole back is covered. It doesn't work all the time, but for these two little ones, it worked. I thought I was going to use these wood veneer letters that we got in the kit for the title, but they weren't big enough. So I'm going to put them back, and then I pulled that paint out and didn't use it on this layout at all. So sometimes that happens. And that's the skyscraper, Mr. Huey's. It's a mini Mister. This is a stamp I got from Coco Daisy that I was looking at here to see if I wanted to use and decide not to. I was looking, that Coco Daisy stamp actually has like if you were to mist something and it's not as random. You know, if you splatter mist, it would be a stamp that you could, it would look like splatter, but it's not as random as splatter is. I thought I would use that, but I decided not to. So all I did was cut a 4.5, 4x6 piece of cardstock out there to cover my photo, and then I misted the bottom and the top corner. And now I'm off looking for some letter stickers, I'm sure, because I need to add a title and my journaling to this. And I still need to find something for that last embellishment cluster. So I'm sure I'm off looking for something. So I pulled out gray thickers, because I thought I would use those. And I really like that one, the wide font. I really liked it. Unfortunately, here you're gonna see it's just too big. I just didn't have enough space. Yeah, I realized right away that I'm not going to be able to use those because it's just too large. It spans too far, and I didn't want the title to come off of that grid paper right there. So I'm going to use this thicker font here, which is narrower, so it all fits. And like I said, the title is going to be Tunnel Vision. There we go. I'm going to pull out some washi tape in a second. Oh, I'm going to. So I used these lime twist mini stickers from My Mind's Eye to add the TV down there. So it says I want, I need TV. Here's the. I'm going to add some gray washi tape to fill in the spacing underneath the title. And I'm going to add that in three places. Always keeping that visual triangle in mind. I'm going to put in my journaling. And the journaling says, when Gabe was smaller, you could put a TV show or movie on and he wouldn't move. It didn't matter how many times you greeted him or said his name, he didn't hear you. This picture was taken on Christmas Eve, and Madison got to witness this firsthand. I didn't want to ignore the fact that Madison was there, but the story was not about Madison. It was definitely about Gabe. So in the journaling, I didn't want to ignore that she was there, but and there was no easy way to cut her out of the picture or cover her up or anything like that. So, in the journaling, I just touched on the fact that Madison was there, but the story is really about Gabriel. So I'm going to use date stamps here. One of them will give us the date. This one's going to say created June 14th, 2013, because I wanted it to be very clear that I'm looking back at this point in time. I'm not scrapping this in real time, and unfortunately, none of the stamps that I have include the date 20 include the year 2006. So I have this Making Memories date stamp thing. Let me see. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what it's called. I bought it when I first started scrapbooking in 2008, I think I started, and it has like all the years, the dates, and the days, and you put them on this mag. They're all magnetic, and they sit on that magnetic stamper handle there, and it's a really good set. I just have a little bit of trouble getting them all to fit back in the case the way they're supposed to. So you see how the case includes the tweezers and the metal handle thing there. So, and there it goes. So it's December 24th, 2006. And I don't know if I realized before the video stops that I need to add something to that third embed. Yep, there we go. So I'm just pulling out some gray buttons to see which one I like best on that embellishment there. And I'm going to choose this lighter gray one there. And then I'm going to pull out some bling, and I'm going to add some black bling around. The journaling and the stamping was done in black. And there is that black, sort of darkish gray, diagonal stripe thing. So I just wanted to pull some black into the layout. And after I did this, it's funny, the black clips that I had pulled out much earlier probably would have worked. I'm much happier with the circular silver ones, but the black ones would have worked now that I've added this black in there. And then we're gonna look at the final picture of the layout. It's kind of a long video. There's the final picture of the layout. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave me any comments or questions you have down in the comment section, and I will see you guys next time.